On Friday, February 10th, President Obama made a statement on his administration's directive of January 20th that most employers and insurers in our country must provide contraception, FDA-approved abortion-inducing drugs, and sterilization to all of its women employees, with very few exceptions. The January 20th ruling drew sharp criticism from the Catholic Church and others, who stated the mandate violated conscience rights as well as constitutional rights to religious liberty. The outcry was strong from Catholics across the spectrum. As a result, the president issued a revision to the mandate, and it's that revision that we will discuss now with Bishop Michael Burbidge. Bishop Burbidge, as we heard, as we watched on Friday, the president made a revision. What is your assessment of that revision?
Well, right now I think it's difficult to give a thorough assessment because we do not know all the details. At the end of the president's statement, that was it. There were not any questions taken from the floor, and I think there would have been many. I'm not sure that all the answers would have been able to be provided. But what we do see in the president's conference of today is that he has heard the very strong voices of Catholic leaders, of faith leaders from various denominations, and people of good faith and goodwill, strongly saying that this original mandate is unacceptable. It must be overruled, must be overturned. I do believe that the administration was a bit startled by the outcry, and we saw it right here in our own building. Never has there been an issue where immediately phone calls and letters and even visits of outrage, of shock. How can our religious freedom and liberty be threatened in such a way? So the president's conference of today is at least an acknowledgement that he's heard the outcry and has opened a door to a way of assuring that, hopefully, seeking a way to assure that the religious freedom and liberty will not be violated. Is that possible? We don't know yet, but we're glad he has at least opened the door.
In his statement, one point he made was that religious organizations such as the church, Catholic hospitals, Catholic universities, will not be required. However, their insurance companies will be. And then the question comes, insurance companies don't give things away for free.
Well, exactly. And so will not be required. Well, it would not even be possible. It would not be possible for the Catholics and our hospitals and our institutions to say, we will provide for you things we don't even believe, we do not believe in. Here, but we'll provide artificial contraception and sterilization and abortion-inducing pills. So now he said, no, you don't directly have to do that. But what it seems like is being said now is that although we do not have to directly do it, we at least have to say, now these things we don't believe in, well, we're not going to do them or directly provide them, but we need, because we're mandated, we need to show you how and where you get this. And then you're right, ultimately, someone's paying for it. And the big concern that we have is who? And is it ultimately the same institution? And these are the questions that have to be discussed and raised, and it's more specific information has to be provided.
In interviews you have done on this topic with local media and in listening to national programs, people point to the fact, oh, surveys show that more than 90% of the women, Catholic women, are using this. And you had a...
Well, the thing is, when you hear polls like that, political strategies will rely on polls. Church teaching does not rely on polls. Church teaching comes to us from the Lord himself, from teaching and from... our own natural law and our great reverence that we have for life and for the dignity of all people. And so we've always have taught that the sexual intimate union, the great gift of intimacy must always be open to the possibility of life. Has that always been popular teaching? But that doesn't matter. It's the truth. And we will continue to teach that. And we will never compromise our beliefs. We can't.
I had one person I spoke to the other day challenged the letter you issued last week to all parishes about the sterilization and the FDA abortion-inducing drugs as being part of this. And she did not ever see it in any of the media. Today, in the statement, the president never addressed those two elements, yet in the fact statement issued to White House reporters, they were included.
See that? He never. Right. But that's never been part of the larger discussion. And I think, you know, that would raise even more serious concern, very grave concern, knowing the whole picture. And that's, I'm very glad that you raised that point.
One of the things, the Catholic Church has been in the headlines regarding this issue, but you touched on this. Other denominations are concerned about this also. The head of the Southern Baptist Conference has raised the issue. He even made the statement that our pastors are willing to go to jail rather than enforce this.
Oh, sure. This isn't just a Catholic Church. This is religious denominations across the board, people of good faith across the board. And, you know, Frank, I think what happens is it's alarming because if particular groups who share these beliefs are being given such a mandate and really being told that you will have to do this, even though it goes against what you believe, what's at the core of your faith and belief, I think others are getting very concerned too. Well, who's next? Mm-hmm. And what else is going to be threatened? And this is where I think the administration really must take a deep look at what kind of imposition is the government having, and to what point are constitutional rights being challenged and threatened and maybe even attacked.
Well, as you said, a lot of questions remain. We don't know exactly. The president's statement was made. A lot of questions remain to be answered. There is one way that we can address this, and that is in Congress. And currently there are two bills, one in each House of Congress, and you have encouraged them in your letter to the parishioners to get involved.
That's right. Just like I think that through the public outcry being so strong, our voice was heard, which led to this conference, this press conference today from the administration. The same effect in a positive way can be given to our elected legislators if we let our voice be heard. And so I am encouraging all the faithful to contact our elected officials and let them know their strong convictions on this issue.
And it comes down to the Conscience Protection Act. Information is available on our diocesan website and also on CatholicVoiceNC.org. Any
Thanks.
Final thoughts?
Thank you, Frank.